Well, as you know, Pope Benedict XVI resigned the papacy in 2013. The day he announced it, lightning struck the Vatican. People took this as a sign that something apocalyptic was happening in Rome. He wrote a letter to a Slovakian gentleman by the name of Vladimir Palko. And Rod Dreher gives us the background information. Palko was a member of the underground Catholic Church, and he went on to serve as the interior minister, and he had some kind of correspondence with the late Pope Benedict. He received a letter from Pope Benedict that he kept private for all these years. And in that letter, as released today, it has these words from the late Pope Benedict. And I quote, "As one sees the power of Antichrist spreading, one can only pray that the Lord will give us mighty shepherds to defend his church against the power of evil in this hour of need." Notably, this letter is dated 2015. That means he wrote this letter after he had resigned the papacy and while Pope Francis was currently on the throne of St. Peter, currently serving as the Roman pontiff. Some are already saying, is this an indication that Benedict thought that Pope Francis was the Antichrist? And I don't think that is the case. I think what Pope Benedict is indicating is that currently we are moving towards some kind of eschatological end time manifestation, and that he believed that the power of the Antichrist was about to be unveiled. Pope Benedict is indicating here that those who will be attacked are those who belong to the body of Christ, the church. And he prays that the Lord will give us shepherds, pastors, who will be able to protect, to defend, and guard the sheep of Jesus Christ. I think this indicates, and I think Benedict would agree with this, that in his lifetime and in our lifetime, now that he's passed away, we live in a time of cowardly pastors, wolves in sheep's clothing. We Catholics have seen decades of sexual abuse, pedophilia, child molestations, embezzlement, all kinds of scandals committed by the men who call themselves shepherds, bishops, and priests. Now, this quote comes to us from Vladimir Palko, I hope I'm saying that correctly, a friend of Rod Dreher. And the question is posed to him, and this is a translation that Rod Dreher provided to Palko. It says, "When you reported the letter for the first time, you decided not to publish part of the text, noting that it was not the right time to do so. The reason was the sensitive content and concerns that the late Pope expressed about the state of the Catholic Church. Could you elaborate on exactly what it was?" Palko, pictured on the screen, says, "Yes, it's like that. The letter is not long. It has 12 lines. In the second half of the letter, there's a sentence about 3 lines long in which the Pope Emeritus makes some striking claims. And then he reads the passage that I read previously. The power of Antichrist is expanding. And then he's asked, what do you think then? What do you think about it today? And he says, concepts such as the expansion of the Antichrist power, the church, in our hour of need, the need to defend the church and the power of evil are serious and weighty, all the more so because they were uttered by a person in whose expression throughout his life, accuracy was combined with the appropriateness of the terms used." Here we see him making the observation, Pope Benedict was always very careful with the way he spoke. He was always very precise. Pope Benedict, if you asked him a question, he would pause. And then the German gears in his mind would begin to turn, and he would prepare an answer in a paragraph form. He would weigh his words, arrange his words, and then speak. That is who Pope Benedict was. So to see this quote that we are entering into the expansion of the power of Antichrist in our time, that's not a throwaway comment. That's something very serious, and we need to weigh it. I think this, the death of Pope Benedict on the 31st of December, of course, the lightning striking the Vatican when he announced his resignation, all of these are apocalyptic signs. Apocalypse, as you know, in Greek means to unveil, to uncover.